Hi dear friends, can we control computers with our mind? Can we use machines with our mind without using any of our limbs? Can people who can't use their arms or legs use their electronic devices with just their brain? What can we accomplish with just our minds? Can we control a robot with our brain? There is an important field of study that tries to answer these questions. It is about easing the life of disabled people. I plan to generally go over the developments in this field. Dear friends, let's ask ourselves these questions. Can a person who cannot use their arms or legs drive a car or play a musical instrument with their mind? These are questions are attainable dreams that experts work on. And don't forget, dear friends, dreams are a starting point for achieving goals. We all probably went through this. When we first learn a new skill like driving a car or playing an instrument, we at first think about every moment and go through the trouble of deciding what to do with our arms or fingers. But after a while, these skills become reflexive. We become much faster in making our decisions and do our movements seamlessly. The tools, vehicles, and instruments become almost an extension of our bodies. I also dream of something with the development of wireless brain computer interfaces. Disabled people may be able to use a machine as if it's a part of their bodies. Why not? By the way, there are already applications of this technology as well as exciting and hopeful developments. We all know that people can play video games, use computers and prosthetic limbs with the help of wired helmets that utilize electrodes. However, the developments in the wireless version of this technology can be really advantageous for disabled people. Chips inserted in people's brains will allow them to wirelessly use their wheelchairs, televisions, and so on, and open and close doors without moving. Wireless brain computer interfaces will allow disabled people to feel the freedom of freely existing in every field of life. The chips that will be put in the brain can measure the electrical signals in the brain and turn them into commands like the electroencephalogram or EEG devices that are being used in medicine. The difference between these EEG devices and the chips is that using helmets that are covered with wires and electrodes to use machines will not be necessary. A team that Elon Musk, who spends a lot of money and time on technological and scientific resources, put together is working on a system of wireless brain computer interface called the NEURALINK. They are even furthering their work they did on pigs on a monkey. The monkey that has a surgically inserted chip in its brain is taught a simple video game. The monkey is given a banana mixture when he is successful in the game of Pong. At first, the monkey plays the game using a joystick and is rewarded with the mixture when he is successful. During this procedure, the monkey's brain activity is mapped using the chip in its brain and turned into computer commands. After a while, the joystick is unplugged, but the monkey is still able to play a game with the joystick in its hand. After more time, the joystick is removed altogether. And although the monkey is confused at first, it continues to play the game with its mind. Also, because it's not losing time by making hand movements, it becomes much more successful in the game. Brown University has also done brain-computer interface research on monkeys for almost 1.5 years, and the results are hopeful. In this research, the brain activity of the monkeys are mapped and used to make a system that turns monkeys' thoughts into computer commands. In short, the tests on monkeys are successful, and it was found out that this would be possible for humans too. I want to share with you that the team of researchers in Brown University have done and what they plan to do. The first part of their plan is to get the necessary permissions to start testing of humans. Then they are going to map people's brain activity. Then they need to design the BCI command box that will be inserted to the brain shell in a manner that will not cause any diseases or infections. After all this is done, the electronic devices that disabled people use will be implemented with special controllers that will be able to receive the wireless signals that come from the brain. In other words, the signals that our brain used to move our limbs will be wirelessly transmitted to machines. This way, disabled people will be able to control specially designed computers, video games, and other electronic devices with their minds. The developments I just talked about, wireless brain-computer interfaces in the near future, using chips inserted in the brain, will be able to send electrical signals to the muscles and allow people who cannot use their legs to walk. Spatial implants placed onto a paralyzed person's leg will form a wireless nervous connection and follow these people to walk like everybody else. Let's imagine this together. Would you like to drive a specially designed high-tech car with your mind without using your arms or legs, or play a game of chess with one of your friends on a specially designed electronic chessboard using just your mind? Imagine you have a robot assistant that you can wirelessly control with your mind. Think about how controlling a robot will ease your life. Scientists and their work allow us to think of scientific dreams that are quite possible. If a system that will allow humans to command electronic devices with their minds will be built, which has already been partly built, especially with the latest developments that are tested on animals, will turn the dreams we had together to real-life applications. People who were once able to walk but now move around with the help of a wheelchair, or a person who couldn't use their legs at all, will be able to walk with the help of these scientific developments. Who knows how happy they will be to be able to walk. Many disabled people will be able to use their electronic devices with the power of their minds. Dear friends, while we are thankful to the scientists that do this research, we are also grateful to our Creator that gifted us our health, mind, brain, intellect, legs, feet, and various limbs and organs. Dear friends, please subscribe to our channel. Share with your loved ones.